Okay, friends, we'll discuss about cone. Now, first of all, I will discuss here, and again, I will recall our definition of cone, and then we'll go towards our particular type of cone. I'm taking one fixed point, and I'm taking lines passes through this fixed point. These are the lines passes through fixed points and intersect one surface or touches to one surface. This is a fixed point. This fixed point is called vertex. These are the straight line passes through fixed points are called generators, and intersect to one surface. This surface is called base surface, base curve or guiding curve. Then such a type of surface is called cone. This is a cone. Now, I will take one particular type of this cone. We are knowing again. This is fixed point, vertex. I'm taking lines, passes through this vertex and intersect to this surface. But here condition is that I'm taking one imaginary line passes through this vertex. This line is called now axis. This is called axis of a cone. Then angle between every generator, angle between each generator and axis of a cone is always constant. This is a theta or alpha. Then this angle is called semi-vertical angle. Now your new thing is angle between every generator and axis of the line is always constant, then such a type of cone is called right circular cone. Or ice cream cone is example of this right circular cone. And one condition, remember that angle between every generator and axis of a cone is always constant. I am taking this generator, then angle between this generator and axis of a cone is again constant. Then this type of cone is called right circular cone. Now we'll discuss about right circular cone. Then what is equation of right circular cone and how to find this equation of right circular cone. To find out equation of right circular cone, first of all, I am taking this vertex. These are the generator intersecting this surface and this axis. Again, we are knowing that angle between axis and every generator is always constant. This angle is theta. This is called semi-vertical angle. I am taking vertex A, alpha, beta, gamma. This is axis of the line whose direction ratios are LMN, this semi-vertical angle theta. Now remember that to find equation of a right circular cone, we must have these three things. Number one, vertex A, alpha, beta, gamma. Then second, semi-vertical angle theta and direction ratios of axis L, M, N. If we know these three things, then easily we can find equation of a right circular cone. But again, keep in mind, to find out equation of a right circular cone, you should have vertex, semi-vertical angle theta and direction ratios of axis of a cone. Now we'll discuss what is method to find, or how we'll find equation of a right circular cone if these three things are given. Now here, I'm taking this vertex A, alpha, beta, gamma, the semi-vertical angle theta and axis with the direction ratios LMN. every time, what we have to do? If all these three things are given, then we have to take always P is a point. I am taking x, y, z. P is arbitrary point on the cone. And here this is on the generator. Any arbitrary point we have to take. Now here I will take a direction. Here this is given. That's why I will write here direction ratios of axis. L, M, N. This is given. As per given data, we are taking direction ratios of axis of cone. Now, we have to find direction ratios of generator. This generator AP, A having coordinate alpha, beta, gamma, B is a arbitrary point on this cone x, y, z. Therefore, we have to find direction ratios of AP. But again, keep in mind, if any vector is given or any line is given, if two points on this line or two points on this vector, here generator, are given, then just a difference between coordinates are nothing but direction ratios of this line. Then A point alpha, beta, gamma, P point x, y, z, these are the two points on the line. Therefore, we have to talk about direction ratios of this generator or line AP as difference between coordinate x minus alpha, y minus beta, z minus gamma. These are the direction ratios of AP. X minus alpha, y minus beta, z minus gamma are the direction ratios of generator AP. Now, if we are knowing direction ratios of axis and direction ratios of line AP, then we will find this angle theta, cosine angle. Again, I will recall about our, in terms of our vector, we are familiar how to find out angle. If A bar vector is known, whose direction ratios I will suppose Lmn, B bar is another vector, whose direction ratios are x minus alpha, y minus beta, and z minus gamma, then we can find angle between two vectors, A bar and B bar. We are knowing this is cos theta is nothing but A bar dot B bar divided by magnitude of A into magnitude of B. B bar and A bar, these two vectors. Same way, we are using here this idea and we will find out here cos theta. Cos theta equal to, we have to take dot product of these two vectors. This is the direction ratios of one vector, direction ratios of another vector. We have to take multiplication. L into x minus alpha plus M into y minus beta plus N into z minus gamma whole divided by under root of L square plus M square plus N square under root of x minus alpha square plus y minus beta square plus z minus gamma square. And this is your formula to find out direction, to find out equation of a right circular cone. Again, keep in mind, to find out equation of a right circular cone, we should have this vertex, semi-vertical angle, semi-vertical angle theta and